The submissions are in for the Groovy and Power Soca Monarch competitions this year, boasting a total of 80 acts going into the preliminary stages of the competitions. Chairperson of the Carnival Planning and Management Committee, Tamara Gibson, says she is pleased with the submissions to the competitions and anticipates nothing short of spectacular performances going forward.
We got many submissions. We're very pleased with the number of submissions that we got. We spent last weekend judging for the preliminary rounds, which will take place this weekend. It's a closed session. Each artist will perform their song live before a panel of judges. What we have found is sometimes the judges, once they have reviewed the submissions and they feel that they meet the criteria, the judging criteria, they make that final decision as to whether those artists can proceed to the next round.
Gibson reveals that updates to the submissions process allowed for a more streamlined approach, thus a more favorable response from St. Lucia's music fraternity.
We accepted digital entries. So we created a form, a digital form, through our website, carnivalstlucia.com, and artists were able to submit their songs with ease from anywhere they were. And we accepted it, we think it worked better. That was one of the areas last year which we felt that we needed to improve upon. And we looked at it, reviewed it, and I think this year the artists could say that it was an improvement than what was there before.
Over the years, there has been a measure of ambiguity concerning the submissions for the Groovy Monarch competition. Oftentimes, artists would argue that a song that doesn't match the criteria would be allowed into the competition. For example, to be eligible to enter the Groovy Monarch competition, a submitted song must not be over the stipulated 140 beats per minute. Anything above that would be categorized as power soca. Yet songs known to surpass that BPM would be allowed into the Groovy Monarch competition. Artists would oftentimes feel like this places them at a disadvantage, as a faster, more upbeat tempo usually gets more crowd response when compared to the slower pace of the renditions on performance night. Shedding some light on this issue at Wednesday's media Q&A was Chairperson of the Carnival Planning and Management Committee, Ms. Tamara Gibson, who says oftentimes some renditions are slowed down to fit the criteria and the judges have the final decision as to whether a song gets into the Groovy competition.
When we receive a submission from an artist, they do have the right to slow down their submission if they choose to, and the judges assess what is before them at the time. So it could be a radio version has a higher speed, but on submission, to be able to meet the requirements to be judged as part of that competition, they sometimes do slow their song down somewhat. And be rest assured, whatever is before the judges, they take in full what the judging criteria is and assess the material before them using that criteria.
The qualifying artists will be required to perform their song in front of a judging panel on Saturday, June 17, 2023. Following that, 20 artists will be selected from each category for the next round of competition on Friday, June 23rd. This show will be open and free to the general public. For the DBS News World, Jason Darius reporting.